portion, what we're going to do is talk about how we're going to prepare your body for the workouts here, okay? So no matter what workout you're doing, we're going to talk about the two different types of stretching that you're going to do to prepare your body. So you guys have probably seen this foam roller. So what we're going to do is I'm going to show you, if you do sit at a desk all day or you drive a lot, I'm going to show you what to do, where to foam roll, to again, like prepare your body for the workout. So I'll have Mia on the ground. And so we're going to show you how to foam roll your quads through here, okay? So what most people want to do because they have low back pain is they want to roll where they have the pain. But in fact, we talked about the tightness being through here, okay? So this is the most important thing on your elbows. Mia's going to go on her elbows. And you want to make sure that you're using this one with the divots. It'll get in there better. And you're going to go all the way down to your knee, where your quads go, and then all the way up, back up to your hips. Okay, so we're rolling this portion from here to here of the body. So you can foam roll before as well as after, okay? Thanks, Mia. And then what we're gonna talk about is the two different types of stretching. There's dynamic stretching and static stretching. Dynamic stretching is a faster, more ballistic type of stretching that we want to do before activity, even in the morning when you wake up to prepare your body for the day or before you go for a walk, anything like that. So dynamic stretching looks like this. Very simple. I'm going to give you a couple for the hips. So what you're going to do is stand up nice and straight. Spine's going to be neutral and you're going to go forward and back like this. And you're going to let your leg hit and use momentum to do the hip swings. Okay, so about 30 each side, and you're gonna do both sides, okay? I'm gonna turn my back to you, and we're gonna do the sides of our hips. Okay, guys, so again, 30 times each side, and just that prepares the hips for all the squats and running that you're gonna do. Now we're gonna talk about static stretching, which is to be done after. And so the guys here do a really, really great job of having you static stretch after the workouts. And I'm gonna go over a few that you can add in as well for the front of your hips. So what we're gonna do is be in this position here, 90 degrees, 90 degrees. And the most common thing is that what we need to do is have your pelvis tilted this way and reach through here, okay? So when you're stretching through here, you don't want to be in this position because I feel no stretch whatsoever here. So I'm going to tilt my hips this way and I really, really feel it all through here, okay? So you can imagine when you're on these treadmills how important it is to be loose through here so that you can get that extension when you're running, okay? The other one that we're going to do, if you guys do yoga, you've probably done this one before. This is called the warrior pose. So again, this will stretch all through here. And then we're gonna rotate this way as well. So these should be done for around 30 seconds. So you're actually holding these exercises after the workout. And again, you wanna get that pelvis tucked this way so that you're really, really feeling it through there. All right, so I challenge all of you to add in these two types of stretching and the foam rolling. So dynamic before with your hip swings and static after. Everyone have a great day.